We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hello, everybody, everybody. Hello, hello. This is Veterans Day Live, and today is the third Sunday of the month, which is dedicated to the women of the military, the power empowering women of the world. And so I'm going to turn it over to the women because, like I said, I'm just introing. I'm not going to say a word after this. So thank you. This is the Veterans Day Live. We have, and if you want to call, it's 323-473-3100. And I take it and let the ladies go. Go ahead.
Hello, ladies. Thank you for coming out to our Veterans Day Live Women Empowerment segment. And we have to our right, Elena, and we have Melynda Douglas.
Hi.
And Elena, tell us all about yourself, how you have empowered women, and how is it that you have any family members that's a part of vets, and tell us all about you.
Well, my husband is a veteran, and back in 2004, 2005, he deployed with the Marine Corps, and his deployment absolutely caught me off guard. I was totally blindsided by what that experience was like, and was surprised by that. You know, I felt that I should know what that, you know, you think they're at war and I'm at home and what's my problem, you know? Right. But what I realized was that there was nothing out in the public media that really showed what it was like to be a military family during wartime. And I had been a news producer and a documentary producer on television and felt that I had the skills to be able to tell the story of military families. And I felt very, very strongly, and still do, that it is important to tell the story of what it's like to be a military family during wartime and what it takes to recover from that. And also what it takes to transition out of the military and what all that entails. And to this day, I still really haven't seen a realistic depiction of what that's like. So I'm really glad to have the documentary finally done.
Right,
and
right.
People can find that at militaryfamilydocumentary.com. But I'm very excited to be able to share that now. I interviewed nearly 100 families for the documentary.
Wow.
Because I really wanted it to be truly a well-rounded look and perspective into what it's like to be a military family during wartime.
All right, good. So can you tell us a little snippet about the documentary?
Sure. I followed two wives before, during, and after their husband's deployment, and also one of the families as they were getting out of the Marine Corps. And it was really remarkable, the things that I didn't know that I discovered in the course of making the film. For example, I didn't know that, you know, families suffer from PTSD, and that if you happen to have your partner deployed at any point of your pregnancy, that you're more than twice as likely to suffer from postpartum depression. And the most urgent thing that I discovered in doing the film is that the suicidal ideation amongst spouses and caregivers and families is increasing, and nobody is talking about this. There's nobody that's tracking the rate of suicide amongst family members. And there are anecdotes that you hear occasionally in the news, but no one's actually tracking the statistics. And these are all things that are preventable, in the sense of you can deal with depression, you know, you can nip things in the bud before they get to the point of anybody thinking about suicide. So for me, it's important to have, you know, a conversation and a dialogue and an awareness so that people can get help before it becomes, you know, such a dire situation.
Okay. I have a friend who fiance has PTSD, and she hasn't seen him for like in a month, and now she's like going through the same thing. She's extremely depressed, and she's like, what do I do? I'm like, I don't know how to help her. I don't even know a route outreach that she could even take. So with you saying that, I definitely would like to some way connect you to my friend, so you can have some way to outreach to her. We're going to take a quick break and come back with another guest, and also finish talking to Elena as well as Melinda, and here we go from here.
There's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way.
don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love in here today. Picket lines and picket signs. Punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on? What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? Oh, what's going on? What's going on?
Hubert's Lemonade, tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle. Xavier Tees and Tots, groundbreaking fashion, forward street smart designs. Tees and Tots for men, women, and boys. Visit xavierusa.com. Once again, that's xavierusa.com.
Sofrenia's design collection, located conveniently in the heart of Los Angeles at 6820 La Tijera Boulevard, Suite 117 near Inglewood, California. Sofrenia's design collection includes beautiful batik fabric fashions, beaded African arts and crafts, plus workshops and classes for all ages. For more information, contact Sofrenia's design collection by calling 310-482-1234. That's 310-482-1234. And be sure to visit the exhibit for Sofrenia's design collection at this year's 23rd annual Pan-African Film Festival, taking place February 5th through the 16th. Again, for more information, contact Sofrenia's design collection at 310-482-1234. Sofrenia's design collection, proud sponsor of the LA Talk Live Business Directory.
Hi, this is Alan Ajoulay with Ajoulay Media Productions. I'm really excited to bring you Groove to the 70s, an indoor live concert event playing Saturday, March 7th, 2015, featuring Smooth Sounds of Santana and Creedence Relive, two of the best tribute bands in America. Tickets are only $29, part of which will benefit Honorable Recharge, a wonderful foundation, nonprofit, assisting combat veterans. Get your tickets now at latalklive.com. Or Facebook, 70s Groovin'. And stick around for the after party with our LA Talk Live DJs Vaneric Marshall and Mario Alvarado, spinning great tunes that will take you back. And check out the option to purchase a VIP ticket for a vet. So come to the Old World Village, conveniently located just off the 405 Freeway and Beach Boulevard in Huntington Beach, for this memorable evening. Bring your friends or that special someone. I hope to see you there.
Welcome back, everybody. We're going to continue with our guest. Elena, can you continue telling us all about you, about your project? And also, we have a special clip we're going to show of your documentary as well.
Well, in part, in terms of the idea of empowering women, I feel that we've been at war for centuries, and yet the story of women, both as spouses, both as parents, has really not been told. So for me, it is important to celebrate and acknowledge all the sacrifices that women have made for all of us to be free and living in the country that we do now. And I also feel that those women and the families need to be supported. And if we don't know what their stories are like, and we can't empathize, because there are people that still believe that being a military family is equivalent of having someone away on a business trip that's long, and that's not the case at all. And so for me, it is really important to encourage, both through watching the documentary and sharing your own stories as a military family and as women in military families, you know, what that is like, and so that people that would like to support military families actually know where to begin.
Because the military women never get a chance to tell their story. Right. They don't have a voice. They don't have an outlet. They never tell a story. For you to do a documentary of this sort would be really phenomenal. Are you ready for the clip now?
Yes, we will.
Okay.
Over 2 million troops have been deployed to Iraq and Afghanistan. Over 2 million families left waiting. This is the story of two of those families.
I was very scared about him having to deploy.
Hey, boys. See, I get back, okay?
Okay, Daddy's got to go.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Say, Sean, don't let anybody else get to you now.
I told him, just know that I'm here for you, just trying to be strong for you.
Tell me where you're sitting.
I love you.
Hold my hand.
I love
Take
you.
My hand.
Love you guys.
Bye, Mama.
Tell Daddy, bye.
So I'll see you.
Love you,
Mama. Love
you
too.
After the goodbyes, the struggle begins.
He woke up 4 times crying. He would remember Daddy's gone, and he would ask me, where's Daddy?
I have not heard from him. I'm always nervous. I hope to hear from him soon, make sure that everything's okay.
My brain just went into overload. I just wanted it to just go away, just stop. And I started thinking horrible thoughts, like, hurting my children and hurting myself.
Whoop, got a little bit of mommy in there.
I just kept asking them, will I be normal again?
This is the journey to healing of America's courageous military families.
So what was remarkable to me is just how generous everybody was in telling their stories, and that the women in this film truly let me into their hearts, into their homes. And you can really see in the film the courage, sacrifice, and love that it takes to be a military spouse, to be a military parent.
Yes.
So I'm just so grateful that they allowed me in so that everybody could benefit from their experience.
Wow. The clip is phenomenal. It's phenomenal. They
Thank
definitely
you.
Have a voice. They have an outlook. Where the military women can like, oh my God, someone actually listened to us. Someone actually filmed what we're going through. So
right.
That's definitely what's a blessing. In 3 words, how are you empowered?
In 3 words.
Yes.
Acknowledgement. Love and support.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're Thank welcome. You.
We have Melynda Douglas.
Hello.
Who father is also a vet, and also she's a celebrity photographer, shooting star photography. Tell us all about you and your as being a child of a vet.
Well, I was born in Germany, Nuremberg, Germany. My dad was in the army at the time, and was very strict. I learned lots of discipline, even till this day, getting up early, making sure things are neat and tidy.
Yes.
He always instilled that in us. I come from a family full of veterans, from uncles, brothers, cousins, and so on. Growing up, my dad, he always filmed and captured just us growing up. In the time that he was away, my mom would take pictures and videotape, you know, so those are things he didn't get to miss when he wasn't around. And from that, I kind of fell into the same thing, doing photography and the love for it. The documentary she did is phenomenal.
It really is.
I'm
Thank
always
you.
Crying over it. And to kind of elaborate on that, I had started doing DVDs for vets. It's kind of more of a slideshow where you
oh,
would
wow.
provide photos, you know, of family members and so forth, and then I would put music and special effects and backgrounds. And it kind of works for when, you know, your husbands or spouses are away, that you can look at pictures and the kids can still see and kind of feel like, you know, your family is still there.
That's
with you.
A blessing.
Yeah. Also, it's just, like I said, I'm still caught on her.
Well, thank you.
Video. I mean, it was amazing to see, and I can't imagine being in that position where, you know, women are home by themselves.
It hasn't been done before, so
right.
For you to come out the box and do that, it's phenomenal.
Exactly.
You definitely have to push
it much
more.
And the live footage of it, right.
Yes.
It's to capture that. Like I said, I couldn't imagine these women are at home by themselves, not knowing, you know, what could happen.
But see, your mom went through that, so
exactly.
You know, your mom understands how the other women would feel because
right.
She went through that.
Right. And like I said, just bringing it into the photography aspect, I think just capturing moments. Like I said, I even pulled out old photos of my dad when he was in the military. And it's, like I said, I just
speechless.
Loose for words.
So how are speechless. You empowered as a woman?
I just feel as a woman, being empowered, like she said, with love and support. And I also feel that as women, we need to support each other and
yes.
and pass on traits and, you know, help each other as much as we can.
Uplift each other.
Very much so.
Definitely.
Definitely just be there, listen, be that ear, like you said, listen. I have a daughter, and I feel I have to be a role model for my daughter, you
yes.
know, because she watches everything that I do. I just feel on, like I said, passing on that trait and your skills, and like you said, uplifting one another. And you can tell I'm very shy if you don't know.
I can tell, but she's so a phenomenal
shy.
Photographer.
Yeah.
So tell us about your photography side. She is a celebrity photographer.
Right.
She does red carpet. She shoots for celebrities. So tell us about that side of your business.
Okay.
How you're empowered through photography.
I love photography. Just the technology, just seeing how the technology, I'm fascinated with digital. I said back in the days, I used to love Polaroid because it was like, oh, this instant picture, even though you had to shake it for a while and get it. But as far as photography, I love just capturing moments for people. As far as getting into the red carpet, I tend to feel that I want to be that best photographer, even though you're out there with 20 different photographers. I just want it to feel like it's me and that person on red carpet, and
right.
no matter what, still try to capture the best image. I just always I have a passion for what I do. You put me on photography, I could talk about this all day.
I can tell when you're like you're less shy when it comes to photography. It's like
right.
that's my love, that's my passion.
I try to use my
that
work.
Actually pretty much empowers you.
Right.
And it empowers you.
I use that. I kind of hide behind it, but I use my work to kind of speak for me.
Okay.
And that's what I do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And we have Brandi Irwin. Brandi's a producer, a cinematography. She does underwater photography. Beautiful
wow.
job.
Thank
you. So you take it from there and tell us all about Brandi and her work.
Thank you, Sabrina. My name is Brandi Irwin, and I got to tell you, I'm just a little cowgirl from Oklahoma that went to New York to chase a modeling career and ended up an underwater filmmaker. Get asked how that happened all the time, and I have no idea. It kind of just fell in my lap. I had an initial idea of shooting fashion underwater, and the universe had a very different plan for me. And I end up doing a lot of work in fluorescence, which is basically the reef glowing in the dark, and working with a lot of educational departments of aquariums across the United States and having exhibits and being kind of a pioneer in fluorescent photography and just being fearless enough to go underwater at night with no lights and
wow.
To bring surface some of the things that have never been photographed before, and to also help educate the younger generation as to figure out why is it this phenomenon is happening.
Right.
And as far as Submerged Media Inc., we're a small-scale production house. We do everything from digital media space to full-feature films with a really, really strong suit underwater.
So how are you empowered as a woman?
Well, you know, it took a long time for me to get my footing and to become empowered, because it seems that life really teaches us some hard lessons.
Yes.
And feeling empowered as a woman, especially I work in a man's industry, I have become very humble. I have become very grateful and thankful. And also stepping into my own self, realizing what it is that what message that I want to put across is a positive one, and something that kids can see and say, hey, if she can do that, I can do that.
Right.
And that's kind of my MO.
Okay. In three words, how are you empowered?
With God.
Best person.
Being very humble. And also from education and learning as much as I can about what I do.
Now, do you have any family members that are vets?
I do. My father served in Germany also.
Oh, wow. Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I have a cousin that is married to a man that's been serving basically since we've been in Iraq. And I do have some family members that were in the war.
Now, having a father that was a vet, did that teach you discipline?
No, because, well, I'll tell you why. My biological father hasn't been a part of my life since I was very young.
Okay.
So I unfortunately didn't get to experience all of that with him. But I imagine that it probably would have had he been around.
Okay. We're going to take a quick break and come back with our new guests, and we'll go from there.
So you didn't phone number.
Oh, you can call in 323-473-3100.
We'll be right back.
Be right back.
Lemonade, tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle. Xavier Tees and Tots, groundbreaking fashion, forward street smart designs. Tees and tots for men, women, and boys. Visit xavierusa.com. Once again, that's xavierusa.com.
Sofrenia's Design Collection, located conveniently in the heart of Los Angeles at 6820 La Tijera Boulevard, Suite 117 near Inglewood, California. Sofrenia's Design Collection includes beautiful batik fabric fashions, beaded African arts and crafts, plus workshops and classes for all ages. For more information, contact Sofrenia's Design Collection by calling 310-482-1234. That's 310-482-1234. And be sure to visit the exhibit for Sofrenia's Design Collection at this year's 23rd Annual Pan-African Film Festival, taking place February 5th through the 16th. Again, for more information, contact Sofrenia's Design Collection at 310-482-1234. Sofrenia's Design Collection, proud sponsor of the LA Talk Live Business Directory.
This is Alan Ajoulay with Ajoulay Media Productions. I'm really excited to bring you Groove to the 70s, an indoor live concert event playing Saturday, March 7th, 2015, featuring Smooth Sounds of Santana and Creedence Relive, two of the best tribute bands in America. Tickets are only $29, part of which will benefit Honorable Recharge, a wonderful foundation, nonprofit, assisting combat veterans. Get your tickets now at latalklive.com or Facebook 70s Groovin'. And stick around for the after party with our LA Talk Live DJs Vaneric Marshall and Mario Alvarado, spinning great tunes that will take you back. And check out the option to purchase a VIP ticket for a vet. So come to the Old World Village, conveniently located just off the 405 freeway and Beach Boulevard in Huntington Beach, for this memorable evening. Bring your friends or that special someone. I hope to see you there.
That's right, this is a family affair. This is the Veterans Day Live show. This is Ladies' Day on Veterans Day Live. Every third Sunday, we dedicate it for the women of the military, children of the military, spouses of the military, anybody, any female, any lady who is affiliated in any kind of way. So with that, without further ado, I'm going to send it back over to Miss Sabrina. And so go ahead, take it away.
Okay, thanks for coming back. And we're going to continue with Brandi. Just to wrap it up with Brandi, so tell us what projects you're working on now.
Submerge Media Inc. is currently working on a TV show. My nickname for being underwater all the time is the girl with the gills. Cute. So we're working on a TV series called Gill Girl. And okay. Basically, she's a fictional superhero character based on a real-life person who is me.
Wow.
And she's just fearless. And she will go and do things that are adventurous, but also for a very good cause. And that's looking to air in 2016. I'm under an NDA, so I can't tell you which network that we're negotiating with right now. And on a topside scale, I'm currently working on a compelling documentary about orphanages in India. And we're going to work on getting some cameras in these kids' hands, and then also getting some cameras in the hands of some privileged children here in Los Angeles, and see what kind of content they come up with, you know, this world versus that world, and see if there are any similarities, and then maybe taking some of the privileged kids over to see how some other children around their same age have to live and that aren't so privileged. And hopefully be able to do a photography exhibit to kind of see what their little eyes see.
Wow, you are an empowered woman. Phenomenal.
Thank you.
You really are. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you for having
me. We have a new guest to the table, Lynique, who is a Mad Diva Concierge. We feature each month a young entrepreneur. She's one of our young entrepreneurs for the month. So tell us all about your service and what you do and how you give back.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Basically, Mad Diva Concierge, I started off as a makeup artist, and I went to school for special effects makeup, and I also have my aesthetics license. So, you know, I'm just very passionate about uplifting women, our young women especially, through beauty and, you know, beauty, fashion, things of the like. And so outside of Mad Diva Makeup, I'm just like, well, there's more I want to do. And so with me having experience in so many different things, I said, okay, let's come up with Mad Diva Concierge. That way I can just basically accommodate people in more than one way besides beauty. So it's basically now a service for beauty, hospitality, and personal assistance. We have mentors that we work with, charities and nonprofits that we like to work with, and basically just, you know, however we can give back to the community. We're all about doing things like that, just trying to stay active in the community and doing different events. I do so much. I also bartend, serve, things like that. So, you know, like I said, just hospitality and just helping people however I can is just mainly what my passion is. So it's like, why not just put everything under one umbrella? So I went from Mad Diva Makeup to Mad Diva Concierge, and here I am just basically trying to give back however I can, keep a smile on people's face, at the same time make sure they're glamorous and all that fun stuff. So
now, do you have any family members or that has been a vet, that is a vet?
Actually, my boyfriend, he actually is one.
And
so,
wow, okay.
Yeah, so, you know, he did serve at one time. And he has kids. I don't have kids, but eventually they want to go into the service as well. So I'm just like, you know, whatever.
Whatever.
But, you know, I am, you know, I hear a lot of stories about vets and things like that.
Has he told you stories?
I mean, we talk about it every now and then. You know, we don't often talk about it. But, you know, I've seen a lot of documentaries and things like that. So, you know, just to know what they go through and what they're doing to fight for the country and things like that, you know, it's very humbling. And, you know, it takes a big person to go out and do that. So
how are you empowered?
I'm empowered just by, you know, I just love anything positive. So anything that's positive, that's for a good cause, just all that stuff just motivates me. I'm always supportive of it, and it moves me. I'm a Pisces, which, you know, we tend to be very emotional anyway. So yes. Just, you know, considering I am a true Pisces, and, you know, our water sign, we feel things. So, you know, if I'm like listening to a story, I can just sit there and start crying. It could be happy tears, sad tears, but, you know, we just really feel things. So just, I'm empowered by anything that's good.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What up and coming projects do you have of it that you're working on now?
Now I'm basically, more so just trying to brand the business and reach out to different organizations and companies to see if we can host more beauty bars and gifting suites and things like that. And, you know, I've been working with a lot of sponsors to bring them on events. I've been doing a lot of bartending, which is kind of separate from the beauty thing. But, you know, so basically beauty and bar, just trying to stay active and get the company more exposure. And, you know, we just did the 50 Shades of Grey movie premiere. So bartending for that was a lot of good networking. So, you know, like I said, just trying to get my feet wet and stay in the know and stay busy.
It's good to have a young entrepreneur woman that's empowered. It's not all about doing the video thing. It's good to see that you have a strong head on you.
Thank you.
I'm glad you came to the show.
Thanks for having me.
So, Elena, tell us, what's the next step for your documentary?
So right now, my mission is to get the word out about the film. I didn't mention the name of the film. It's called While Time Stands Still.
Okay.
And also to get families, spouses, parents, siblings sharing their stories. And so it would be great, anybody that would like to do that on the Facebook page, which is Facebook and then While Time Stands Still.
Okay.
Because in part, the important thing is to create a dialogue and to let people know what's going on in terms of what military families go through during war. And then if anybody wants information about the film, they can find that at militaryfamilydocumentary.com. So really it is right now about letting people know that the film exists.
Spreading the word, please.
Absolutely, absolutely. Because on some level, families don't even recognize the trauma that they've been through, and you can't, in a way, heal a wound that you don't know exists. And you try very much sometimes to sweep it under the rug and move on, but that's the kind of poison that seeps into your life, and you don't even know where it came from. So if you know it's there, you can sort of tend to it and take care of it and be able to move forward in a healthier way.
Okay. If anyone would like to call in, now's a good time, 323-473-3100. You guys want to say anything else about empowering women, about your projects?
If anyone has anything that Mad Diva Concierge or Mad Diva Makeup can assist with, please add us on Instagram. We love to hear what you have going on and definitely possibly be a part of it.
Okay.
I guess what I would like to say is, in general, if you feel very strongly about something and you feel a sense of mission, you know, go out and do it. Don't let any obstacles come in your way. You need to start living your life now. And you know, in the course of the journey, it doesn't mean that it's always going to be easy,
right.
But that doesn't mean that you're on the wrong path. You know, to keep going forward and know that it's going to be the most rewarding thing that you do.
Thank you. Nice words. Brandi?
I will say thank you for having me today.
Thanks
and thank
for
you to all of you that I've had the pleasure to meet. Empowering women is a very powerful thing, so I'm honored to be in your presence.
Same here.
And I would like to give the message that positivity attracts positivity, and the law of attraction is really well. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, you will achieve.
Yes, thank you. We're going to take a quick break and come back with our other guests.
We'll be right back.
Hello, everybody. We back. You all in the camera, man. Come on, man. Don't be. Come on, man. All right, we back once again. This is the Veterans Day Live Show. I'm your I am your host, but today I'm not going to be hosting the show. This is the Women's Military Show, where we dedicate the third Sunday of every month to the women of the military, spouses of the military, girlfriends of the military personnel, so on and so forth, and even children. So I'm going to go around the table, and I'm going to ask a few questions. You know, Sabrina, why did I get a gift bag?
No, I'm you're not a woman? How
no,
about
that's
that?
All right, but I got lady friends. But anyway.
They're not important right here. Yeah, these women right here are important. They're
yeah,
power. Okay,
but anyway, okay, thank you. Elena, so what made you, like, you know, wanting to do something like this to help other wives, girlfriends, and that kind
of
stuff?
Well, after I went through the experience of having my now husband deployed, I felt like I had a really hard time, and we didn't have kids. You know, I felt that other people were in a much more difficult situation than I was, and we were very fortunate that he came back safe and healthy, and I wanted to be of service to the people that weren't so lucky. And having been a television producer and documentary filmmaker, I felt that what I could do is to be of service doing what I do, so that I could help, you know, celebrate and validate the experience of other people that had had this experience of going through the traumatic, you know, the trauma of having a loved one, you know, go to war, and what that's like to make it through, and what it like to have to put the pieces together afterwards, because just because they're home, that doesn't mean it's over.
Exactly. So is there anything that you can tell people, you know, the ladies who are maybe going through that, you know, if you want to, you know, how you cope with that, him being away even now? You say he's deployed over there now?
No, he's back now. He's actually out of the Marine Corps now.
Okay.
Yes.
But is there anything you like to say to those young wives, girlfriends, and so on and so forth that are experiencing that vacancy?
Absolutely. I mean, what I want to say is that your experience is very true and valid. It's not all in your head. That when you're in a position to be under such extreme stress and to be fearing for the life of the person that you love and not knowing, you know, that each moment could bring the worst news of your life, that causes it causes extreme duress on you physically, emotionally, psychologically, and to take care of yourself, which is very easy to say. And the thing is that, like I said, when they come back, that doesn't mean that it's over. So don't expect, like I did, that when he, she comes home, that you're just going to cry on their shoulder and that everything's going to be fine. And I don't mean just for them, which obviously we need to make sure that the service member is okay, but even for you. And a lot of times the spouse, especially if they have children, they don't have time to take care of themselves because they're too busy holding up, you know, the fort, you know, taking care of the kids. And they and people feel that if they take a moment for themselves that they're going to crumble and then their whole family infrastructure is going to fall apart. But what I would like to say to those people is that if you don't take care of yourself, it may not be today, but tomorrow or the next day, it's going to be far worse.
Right. Okay. Well, thank you for that. And Ms. Oliver, is that correct?
Lynique.
Yes. Okay, because I'm reading here and it has look, Oliver. But anyway, that's my fault. Okay,
yeah, it is.
You know what I mean? Because I'm just reading what I'm saying. You know what I mean? But anyway,
reading the wrong Lynique, thing.
Reading the wrong thing. Yeah, exactly. Lynique Bowling. Browning. Mm. Browning. Is it right? Browning. Miss Browning.
Yes.
All right. So what? When did you discover that you want to be your own entrepreneur, you know, your own boss, you didn't want to work with anybody, you know, like, anything like that?
Well, just in high school, just I've always had that drive. I was just always the one out of my friends. Hey, everyone, let's all get together. We can go do group photos, and it'll only cost us this much if we all put in together. I was just always organizing and just always doing something. And they're just like, oh, gosh, just here she comes, always trying to put together some type of game plan. And, you know, and just okay. That's basically just I've just always had that hustle and drive and ambition to just, you know.
So that was in high school?
Yeah, in high school. Like, even when I was in junior high, me and my sister, we used to do little hot glue gun lace, little baskets, and all that little fun stuff. Okay. So, you know, we've always just been into different little things. But, yeah, just, it's, it's better not having anyone. You still, of course, have someone to answer to, because, of course, you want your clients to be happy. But, you know, it's just when you're working for someone else, it's not really designed for you to rise above them, of course. So it's just kind of better to venture off and do your own thing, especially if it's something you're passionate about, if it's going to help others. So basically.
Right, right. Well, we have a phone call, as I see. So let's see what the phone call is about. And I'm going to let everybody get back on there to see here. and turn the music off, because evidently the music's still on. So let me see. Carla, what's your name and where you're calling from?
Estrella Harrington. Estrella Harrington.
Miss Harrington, how you doing today?
Good, how are you?
Okay, so you couldn't come in today. Oh, you're a call-in person. Okay.
Estrella's from Garter Heart Nonprofit. So she's calling in to tell us about Garter Heart Nonprofit, as well as the upcoming event they have for the Oscars.
All right, well, go ahead. Yes. So go ahead. Continue.
So, Estrella, tell us about Garter Heart, the nonprofit, and how it supports heart attacks and things of that nature.
Yes, we are a nonprofit. Our mission is to learn, detect, prevent. We want people to know that heart disease is preventable, and we want people to know their risk of having a heart attack beyond just a normal traditional cholesterol testing. Because 50% of people that have a heart attack have actually normal cholesterol. And so that's what we do. We go out, educate the community, we work with physicians, and to encourage people to be proactive about their heart health, because it is preventable. Ironically, it's the number one killer, and it's also the major cause of disability in the United States and also in the world. A lot of people don't realize that. Especially women, that every minute there is women that either die or have a heart attack.
Wow.
Every minute. The new AHA guideline just published that, and that's very sad.
How long have you guys been a nonprofit?
Since 2011.
Okay,
that's good. Do you have anybody who's affiliated with the military anyway?
Yes, we do. Our president is actually ex-military Vietnam vet veterans. We work with a lot of the military people and also the VA hospitals, and we support a lot of the military families. We really appreciate what they do for us.
Well, I appreciate what you're doing for everyone.
Thank you.
Yeah, so you can hang on the line if you choose to. But we're going to keep continuing this.
Can you tell us about, I know you have an upcoming event for Oscars. You want to speak on that real quick?
Yes, we have an event this coming Sunday. It's an Oscar viewing party, and it's also a masquerade ball. We wanted to invite the community to join physicians and community leaders to help promote, you know, heart disease awareness, unmask heart disease. That's what the theme. And that's the whole evening. It will be full of education and fun.
All right. Thank you. You can hold on and continue listening to our other guests. We have another caller calling in?
Not yet.
Okay.
No, but in a few. But thank you for calling in. Any other questions
you
have for Sabrina?
How do you empower women?
How I empower women. I believe women are very, very courageous, very tough, and very smart. And sometimes we feel somewhat discouraged, or sometimes women are afraid to speak out, or are worried about certain things and feel like we have to get an approval from somebody to do something. But what I want women to know is women are powerful, they're smart, beautiful, wonderful, and also they're actually a big encouragement, not only for the community, but also for their family. They're also a big encourager for their spouses if they have husbands, for their children, everybody. And every strong and powerful man, there are powerful women out there. And I want women to know that. And so I encourage them to stand up and be all they can be.
Well, thank you, Dad. One more thing. Let everybody know exactly how to get to, if they want to attend to your event, the address and how they can...
The website
and all that.
Yes, the website is unmaskheartdisease.com, and we have limited access to the event, and we also have certain dignitaries that are coming to the event. So if you RSVP, then they we will send you the event location. So if people want to attend the event, they should register at unmaskheartdisease.com.
All right, well, thank you. Thank you very much. I see we have another caller on the line, so I'm going to add that caller to the line.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks for calling. See yeah, you thank next you
for Sunday. Caller, what's your name? What you're calling for? What's your... Hello?
Yes, this is Tonya Moore with BET Networks. How are you?
How you doing,
Tonya? How are you?
Thank you for calling.
I'm doing wonderful. I've been traveling and I just got back, but I'm calling in.
Good.
See how you guys are doing.
Good. I want you on the show because I know you with BET Networks. I want you to just tell us a little bit about your job and what you do with BET and how what you do encourages other women.
Yes, well, at the end of the day, I do work at BET. I am the event manager there, and what I do is we pretty much specialize in making sure our guests have the ultimate guest experience for any of our live events or any of our televised events. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And we're like the brand ambassadors. We make sure that we ensure that the brand is properly represented. So we do anything from guest invitations to building red carpets, dealing with the vendors with the red carpets, setting up the contracts with the venues, travel for talent. I mean, just anything that touches putting any live event together or production for televised event is what I do full-time. But aside from that, I am a veteran, and I work with a lot of women veterans where we try to help give back and help them transition from being in the military to civilian life.
Yes.
And then I also work with teen girls from the ages of 12 and 19, just teaching them about positive self-esteem and self-image and self-love.
Well, thank you for that. What branch of the military are you in or were you in?
I was in the Air Force.
Okay. Cool. Okay. How long did you do?
I did 6 years.
Okay. How was your basic training?
Basic training was awesome. It actually was awesome. It, you know, I am a girly girl, but I also have that tomboy side in me. So going through basic training kind of touched that side of me, you know, climbing over walls and confidence courses. And it really helped me mentally as well because, you know, most of the time what they do is try to break you down to build you right back up. So it teaches you how to just go through things and, you know, you have a mission and you stay focused and you get to that mission. And it also teaches you about teamwork and working together. I am my brother's keeper.
Well, with you being a vet, that gives you discipline with work with BET, child.
Yes, because you deal with so many different personalities.
Woo, child.
Characteristics and egos, so you have to be able to, you know,
have that discipline.
Keep a
yes.
smile and serve.
Solid. Yes. Okay, cool. Yes. So you're going to be letting people know at BET about LA Talk Live and the Veterans Day Live Show. I'm quite sure.
Absolutely. Actually, that's where I just came from. So I apologize for getting in late, calling in late. But this weekend, Challenge America, they did a event in Richmond, Virginia, at University of Richmond, where we gave back to the women there. And we partnered with Dresses Across America. And they gave a military person a wedding. So we did a wedding and they gave away dresses and gowns for the wedding, and it was a workshop to teach you, you know, Mary Kay came in and they did makeovers and, you know, they talked about resume building and building your brand. So it was a really, really great event with a whole bunch of women there.
That's empowerment. Awesome. That's definitely empowerment. We need to do that here. So when you come out here, we can do that out here with BET.
Absolutely. Well, BET didn't do that one. It was an organization called Challenge of America.
Oh, I love
it.
We should do that.
But, you know, I have a thing. I actually was one of the speakers on the panel.
Okay.
And then I was able to, I have a debut single that I just released on Veterans Day. And I was able to perform the song at the ceremony. So it was awesome.
So when you come out here in May, make sure you come on the show and meet everybody, meet the team, Van, Richard, and Big Dre, so, you know, you can show your single and so we can see what you're working with. So how are you empowered, Tonya, besides work for BET?
How am I empowered?
As a woman.
I'm empowered by giving back. At the end of the day, you know, I love BET. That's my job. I love them, and that's my family. However, I feel empowered when I'm able to give back what God has given me and share with someone else and let them know that they can be whatever they want to be, whatever their dreams are, whatever their goals are, you know, just giving back and making a difference. Because at the end of the day, you want to leave something. When you die, when you leave this earth, you want to be able to, you know, leave a legacy. You want to be able to say that somebody, you helped somebody, you know.
Yes.
It's not just about me, but it's about everything that we go through. I believe we go through it to help someone else, to make them better, you know.
Yes.
So that's how I feel like I'm empowered, by empowering somebody else to let them know that they can be whatever it is they want to be.
Very powerful words. Thank you. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Okay. Yeah. Well, we're going to go to another break because we're going to bring the lady who's standing over to my immediate left so she can get back in. And that phone number for those late callers,
323-473-3100.
And we'll be back in a few. We got to pay some bills.
Thanks, callers.
Yes, so we're outstanding. Well, I want to
be an independent woman.
Lemonade, tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle. Xavier Tees and Tots, groundbreaking fashion, forward street smart designs. Tees and Tots for men, women, and boys. Visit xavierusa.com. Once again, that's xavierusa.com.
Sofrenia's Design Collection, located conveniently in the heart of Los Angeles at 6820 La Tijera Boulevard, Suite 117 near Inglewood, California. Sofrenia's Design Collection includes beautiful batik fabric fashions, beaded African arts and crafts, plus workshops and classes for all ages. For more information, contact Sofrenia's Design Collection by calling 310-482-1234. That's 310-482-1234. and be sure to visit the exhibit for Sophronia's design collection at this year's 23rd annual Pan-African Film Festival, taking place February 5th through the 16th. Again, for more information, contact Sophronia's design collection at 310-482-1234. Sophronia's design collection, proud sponsor of the LA Talk Live Business Directory.
Hi, this is Alan Ajoulay with Ajoulay Media Productions. I'm really excited to bring you Groove to the 70s, an indoor live concert event playing Saturday, March 7th, 2015, featuring Smooth Sounds of Santana and Creedence Relive, two of the best tribute bands in America. Tickets are only $29, part of which will benefit Honorable Recharge, a wonderful foundation, nonprofit, assisting combat veterans. Get your tickets now at latalklive.com. or Facebook 70s Groovin', and stick around for the after party with our LA Talk Live DJs Vaneric Marshall and Mario Alvarado, spinning great tunes that will take you back. And check out the option to purchase a VIP ticket for a vet. So come to the Old World Village, conveniently located just off the 405 freeway and Beach Boulevard in Huntington Beach, for this memorable evening. Bring your friends or that special someone. I hope to see you there.
We're back, ladies. They can hear us. Welcome back to the Veterans Day Live Show with the ladies of the Run the World. We're getting ready to close on up, so we're going to go around the table and do our last remarks. So go ahead, Miss Sabrina.
Well, ladies, can you let our public know how they can reach you and follow you, Instagram, your social media?
So you can go to militaryfamilydocumentary.com to get a copy of the film, and please come and share your story on Facebook, and there you will find it by the title of the film, which is While Time Stands Still.
Please support. It's a great. The snippet was phenomenal.
Thank you.
Melinda?
Yes, I wanted to say I have a couple of events, red carpet events coming up. One that I'm working with you, Sabrina, the speaker that we just had for God Her Heart, will be doing that red carpet event. And just anytime you're out there on the red carpet, you see me, look at me, give me a smile. you can follow me. I'm on Facebook at MD Brickhouse, and that's BRIKHOUZE. Also, I have a couple of projects that I'm putting in, just private events and things. Again, things that I post on Facebook, so you can always check me there. Want to say hi to my son and daughter. I know they're watching, and probably my mom with her camcorder videotaping live, so hi. And just thank you for having me on the show. I appreciate it.
Thanks pleasure. For being a part of my team. She's a, I have a Film Girl production, which empowers women through film, television, and music. She's a part of my team.
Sabrina's fantastic. Helped me out a lot with a lot of events, so I appreciate it. Thank you.
Miss Brandi.
Yes, Ladybug.
Last words, social media, where they can reach you, follow your work.
Yeah, I'm Brandi Irwin. You can find me at liquidfilmphotography.com, submergedmediainc.com. And I'm a kind of a Facebook hater, so I'm on Instagram at The Girl with the Gills Official, because Instagram seems a lot more nice than Facebook these days.
Yes, that's true. So now we're going to go to announcements, please.
All right. Well, the VA and community partners released the West Los Angeles Homeless Plan. On January 28, 2015, U.S. Department of Veterans Secretary Robert A. McDonald and attorneys representing homeless veterans in Los Angeles announced a historic agreement that dedicates the West Los Angeles VA campus to serving veterans in need. This agreement is an important step forward in carrying out President Obama's commitment that no vet should live on the streets or forgo available medical and psychological services. Today, pursuant to this agreement, VA is releasing its written plan to help end veteran homelessness in Greater Los Angeles. The plan focuses on serving veterans, particularly homeless veterans, women veterans, aging veterans, and veterans that are severely disabled. VA's efforts will be done in coordination with pertinent federal, state, and local authorities, legislators, veterans service organizations, faith-based organizations, community partners, charitable organizations, and veterans. As part of this plan, VA is committed to utilizing the West Los Angeles Medical Center in a more veteran-centric manner going forward. And so there's actually a 22-page plan actually fully carried out, and you can find this at www.va.gov. All right.
Well, thank you there, TJ, for doing that. You know, she's been doing our announcements for the show because, again, this show wants to want to let all veterans, men and women, know what's out there because for some reason, for some strange reason, the government doesn't want it to be public information. So everybody who's involved some kind of way with the military, organization to be nice, needs to know about these organizations that's available to them. You know, I don't understand why it's so hush hush. You know, and I appreciate you ladies coming out here today and doing what you do, because there's women who are listening to this show, watching this show, need to hear and see you women, and that will give them the strength to carry on, because again, without you ladies, a lot of other women will probably give up. And so I commend you with this type of applause.
Thank you.
With the studio audience, you know what I mean? They just clap when they want to clap, because you know, in the beginning, oops. So anyway, thank you, Sabrina.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know, for bringing these ladies together. And once again, I'm gonna close out my goodness. What should I play here? I'm gonna play what we started off with. So thank you, Wave. Do the Miss America Wave. We're out of here.
Thanks for support and thanks for tuning in.
All right, take care, everybody.